San Gabriel Mission is the fourth of 21 missions built in what was once Nueva España, or New Spain. It was founded September 8, 1771. It lies on El Camino Real, or the Royal Road. It has suffered natural disasters and fires over the past 230 years, but the walls, which are 4 feet thick, are original. A statue of Father Junipero Serra stands in front of the mission. He was important in helping the Spanish colonize what is now the state of California. He has been called the Apostle of California and personally founded 9 missions. You can peek into the Campo Santo Cemetery. It is the oldest cemetery in the county of Los Angeles. Come along with us as we walk onto the grounds of the San Gabriel Mission, the pride of the missions. Here we are in the main entrance next to the gift shop. Hey, we just got here and my sister Kimberly already wants a snack, but Papa isn't buying. Check out the neat projects. Once inside the mission, Kim and I head for the fountain to make a wish. My wish is for my dad to stop videotaping. That wish didn't come true. This is one of the many gardens in the mission. It is called the Peace Garden. The mission gardens have native California and non-native plants and flowers. In the Peace Garden, you will find a 90-ton anchor that was made at the mission using mission Indians as workers. It was used for the first ship built in California using all native materials. The cannon was found in a nearby river after a flood. The tile picture of Our Lady of Guadalupe is handmade. This tile is of Father Junipero Serra. It shows that he was born at Petra, on the Spanish island of Mallorca, Spain, in 1713 and died in 1784 at the age of 70.
What are you gonna do now, Ashley?
Whatever I feel like I wanna do. God!
This is the old kitchen. Meals for the soldiers and friars were prepared here. It is a replica of the original kitchen that was destroyed by a fire. It was rebuilt on the original foundation. These stone implements were used by the Mission Indians to pound wheat and corn to make flour and grind meat to make meatballs and tortillas. These stones were dug out of the ground during the excavation in the quadrangle. This is the Court of the Missions. It contains models of the 21 missions created by Claritin clergy in the 1930s. Here we are at the tannery vats. They were used to process cowhides into leather. The leather was then used to make leather goods for mission use and also for trade. Leather was the mission's most valuable trading good. The soap and candle factory was made up of four deep cone-shaped pits lined with brick, stone, and lime. They held around 2,000 to 2,500 gallons. Large iron pots or kettles sat within the pits that were called furnaces or boilers. Fire from within furnaces kept the pots boiling. The pots were stolen during the Mexican War. San Gabriel Mission supplied the other missions with their soap and candles. The aqueduct was very important to mission life. It provided the only water supply, which came from Wilson Lake a few miles away. The water was transported through the use of crudely made fire clay pipes. The pipes provided water to the kitchen, laundry, and other areas. The aqueducts made it possible for the dry desert land to have an abundance of fruit. The open fireplaces were used after the kitchen was destroyed in 1812. Iron kettles were used to prepare beef and corn for Indians. Yummy popcorn soup. Olive trees were grown in groves at the mission. Seedlings from the olive grove produced oil to fuel the lamps. In addition to olive groves, the mission planted figs, plums, peaches, and pomegranates. The Franciscans at the mission planted the first orange grove in all of California. This is the quadrangle. It was the birthplace of the Shoshone Gabrielino Indians. The Franciscan padres and craftsmen from Mexico taught the mission Indians many skills. The Indians became skilled in leatherworks, metal smelting, soap making, candleworks, weaving, and carpentry, just to name a few. The quadrangle also contained sleeping quarters for the padres, various workshops, guest rooms, infirmary, and the monjerio, where women were separated from the men. This is the original winery. Inside you will find grape and olive presses that were used by the Franciscans and Mission Indians.
Thank you.
In 1834, through the use of Mexican decrees or rules, politicians and influential colonists came together to take possession of the mission land from the Franciscans and mission Indians through secularization. The final sale of mission property arranged by Governor Pio Pico in 1862 was prevented by arrival of U.S. troops through action of the American Congress. James Hennessy, the author of the book entitled American Catholics, A History of the Roman Catholic Community in the United States, wrote, "With Mexican independence from Spain came the disintegration of the government of the missions, always intended to be someday turned over to the Indians who inhabited them. The rapid and chaotic secularization that occurred in 1834 resulted instead in the enrichment of local politicians, the displacement of the native residents, a temporary halt to religious functions, and, sometimes, the physical destruction of the missions themselves." At time of confiscation, the mission had over 12,000 head of cattle. In 6 short years, no more than 100 remained.
So what do you think?
It's pretty cool, I guess.
This is pretty much the worst video ever made.
Napoleon, like anyone can even know that.
You know what, Napoleon? You can lead.
Ha 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 ha